Let's head to Parliament now because the House will next week Tuesday make a determination on the Sputnik V investigation that it was unable to in the last meeting of 8th Parliament. The committee presented its report to the House, but the second Deputy Speaker, Andrew Amaku Isiama, deferred the question on the motion. The minority in Parliament pushed for the Health Minister to be sacked, even though the committee did not recommend it after it found the minister to have breached aspects of the procurement law. Thank you, Komla Kluche, our Parliamentary Affairs correspondent, is joining us for a conversation. Komla, do we know exactly the details or the circumstances under which this particular matter was deferred to next week, Tuesday?
Well, it's supposed to be taken on Thursday, which would be on the 4th of November. This is contained in the business statement that was presented by the Deputy Majority Leader, Alexander Penyumakins, to the House a short while ago. You will recall, like you did read in that intro, that the House had gone into the report presented by the ad hoc committee, which he chaired himself, together with the ranking member on the Health Committee, Governor Kando, on the Sputnik V, Sheikh Ahmed Muk Al Maktoum, SL Global, for the supply of the Sputnik V-19 vaccine, which at the time had not come. Some amount had been paid. Subsequently, we were told that money had been paid to government test after the committee found out some money has been paid to Al Maktoum, and that transaction had gone on. In fact, the House had delved into the matter, the presentation of the report, which was on the eve of them, the day they were going to rise last year. But the House did not make any vote on the matter. In fact, the Speaker, then the second Deputy Speaker, Andrew Sim, deferred the matter because of some controversy of the sort. Well, the very last time we spoke to the majority leader of St. James Raboso, he said he was surprised the speaker put the question at the time. But it is back again now, and that they expected that it will be moved and a decision will be taken by the House on the matter. By that decision, the speaker is going to have to put the question. If he puts the question, then the House would make a determination of it, and then that matter would come or will see a finality. Then this has been moved from Friday already. The motion has been moved. So it's only left for the Speaker to put the question, and then the House will go ahead to make a decision on the matter.
What else has been happening on the floor of Parliament today?
As I speak with you, the issue of the 499 failed law entrance exam student is before the House. This also was raised by the Deputy Majority Leader, Alexander Penyumakins. In fact, he was very displeased about the report, the continued failure of students by the General Legal Counsel and the Ghana Law School over this whole issue. Now, he is asking Parliament, and I must tell you that the whole House, both sides of the House, both the majority and the minority, are unanimous in their condemnation of the General Legal Counsel and the Ghana Law School over what it described as, so to speak, a deliberate attempt to fail their students. They think that the criteria they are using as a marking scheme needs to be reviewed. They are asking the Chief Justice to, as a matter of urgency, go into the matter and bring finality to it, because it is not helping at all when it comes to legal education in the country.
Right.
They make the case. Speaking to you now, Alexander Penyumakins is done. Minority Chief Mubarak Muntakam is on his feet, and I can tell you they are venting their anger on the system or the General Legal Counsel, that they think that they are deliberately denying students from legal education. It is uncalled for. The Chief Justice, they are saying Parliament must make a case. Parliament must stamp its authority as representatives of the people, that the General Legal Counsel and the Chief Justice at the Ghana Law School must obey for or in the interest of the people.